Every creature in nature has different qualities depending on the conditions prevalent in the place where it lives. Some animals hide themselves using camouflage techniques. That is, they cannot be detected in their environment because their appearance blends in with the colors and designs of the place where they live. Some animals role-play, and others resort to clever tactics. Now, let's look together at these interesting characteristics that animals have and see some examples of God's creative art in nature. Camouflage. Pay close attention to what you are about to see. Can you see any animals hiding here? Not easy, is it? Let's look together. Here is a white spider. Here is a snake as still as a branch. A toad hidden among dry leaves. All these are interesting examples of camouflage in nature. And they show us that camouflage is a specially created method for hiding. Some creatures have a color and design that matches the ground cover of the place where they live. For example, it is very hard to notice a tiger hidden in the yellow grass. Lions are created with the color of the plains they live on. For this reason, they can easily hide in the dry grass. Some masters of the art of camouflage live in the world's coldest lands in areas near the poles. Polar birds. It's autumn. Snow has fallen on a rocky area. There are two birds hidden here. Can you see them? There they are. It is nearly impossible to see them in the natural environment where they live because they have wonderful camouflage in their feathers that looks the same as the ground. Now, let's look a bit more closely. The white feathers of the birds are a copy of the snow covering. The patches of the ground remaining among the snow are also carefully marked on the birds' wings. The ground and the birds look the same. It is almost impossible to distinguish between them. It's winter. Everything is covered with snow. There is a miraculous change on the bodies of the polar birds. They have no dark feathers left. Again, it is almost impossible to make out the white bird in the snow. The bird does not realize it, but its body is perfectly camouflaged. The black feathers around its eyes prevent it from being blinded by the light reflected from the snow. Now it's springtime. The snow has begun to melt. Plants have begun to emerge from the melting snow. New feathers have appeared on the bird's body. They are the same color as the new plants. And now it's summer. The snow has all melted and the ground cover has appeared. Again, the bird displays a remarkable camouflage. You will notice that there is a deliberately planned change in the bird. Its body is covered with feathers that match the design of the ground cover. Again, it's almost impossible to see it in the grass. Let's think a bit about this marvelous display of camouflage. The bird cannot adjust the color of its feathers to match the environment by itself. It does not have the intelligence to realize what use its camouflage serves. In that case, who gives it its remarkable camouflage ability? Who knows the kind of camouflage the polar bird must have in every season? Who marked the colors and designs of the environment on the feathers of the bird just like an artist? There's only one answer to these questions. God created the bird, and it is He who gave it its qualities. Various examples of camouflage. Animals with camouflage not only live on land, but are also to be found in the seas. Look, this fish at first seems to be hiding in seaweed. But when you look more closely, you see that this is not the case. It is not seaweed, but a seahorse created to look like seaweed. This creature that at first looks like a sea sponge is actually a fish. There are two bumps on this branch, but one of them is a camouflaged spider. The spider camouflages itself again at moments of danger, and you can't distinguish it at all from a real bump on the branch. There's an insect hidden in these leaves. Right there. You will notice that there is no difference between the body of this insect and the real leaf. Every detail has been flawlessly created down to the leaf-like veins on it. There is another insect in these yellow leaves. Let's try to find it. Here is a perfectly camouflaged insect. It is almost impossible to see it on the leaf. The insect's wing has all the subtle details of a yellowing leaf, down to its spots and discolorations. Here is another insect that looks like a section of a leaf. Now let's think a bit about the camouflage designs on these creatures. These creatures can't think. They are not aware that they need to look like a leaf in order to survive. Even if they were aware, they could not draw the shape of a leaf on their bodies. So, who produced these drawings so deliberately designed on the wings of these creatures? These drawings are certain proof of the Creator who brought these creatures into existence. The Creator who made this creature with such a wonderful design and showed His artistry and power to us in this way is Almighty God, the Lord of all the worlds. This object swinging on a branch looks just like a dried leaf in its color and shape. But it is not a dried leaf. It is actually a butterfly cocoon. Because of the perfect method of camouflage that God gave it, the defenseless caterpillar inside completes its development unnoticed by its enemies and emerges as a new butterfly. This white spider is waiting for its prey right on the edge of the white part of a flower. In this way, from the point of view of a butterfly alighting in the center of the flower, the spider is the same as the color and design of the leaves. The spider is so well camouflaged that the butterfly sometimes lands on it without noticing. Now you are seeing a pink orchid. But not all of what you see is part of the orchid. There is another creature that fits in totally with the color tones and even the shape of the flower. It is a perfectly camouflaged praying mantis. This perfect similarity in shape, design, and color is certainly nothing the mantis designed itself. Almighty God, who created all things, shows us His artistry once again in this example. In a verse of the Quran, God tells us that He created living things perfectly. He is God, the Creator, the Maker, the Giver of Form. The Camouflage of Butterflies. Among the wonders of camouflage in nature, butterflies occupy a special place. Huge eye designs have been placed on the wings of some species of butterfly. These false eyes constitute one of the butterfly's most important defense tactics. Whenever the butterfly is in danger, for example, when it meets a bird looking for something to eat, it opens its wings wide. Now it looks like the face of a huge creature. Seeing these false eyes, the bird quickly flies off. Who does this design on butterfly wings belong to? Such a design could not be the result of chance, as some people claim. This design on butterfly wings shows us once again the creative artistry of God. Apart from its false eyes, the butterfly has other amazing camouflage abilities. Butterflies alighting on a plant can blend in with the colors of that plant. In order to be able to do this, it first has to examine the plant and then change its body to that color. But a butterfly can't do that. This design in butterflies is a clear proof of creation. The patu bird that lives in the jungles of Venezuela is a master of camouflage. The color of the bird's feathers and the color of the bark of the tree it sits in are created the same. Let's look carefully. You can see on the screen the tree bark and the bird's feathers together. The tree is on the left and the bird is on the right. A perfect similarity. The only hint that could give the bird away is its bill and its eyes. But the bird knows how to use the design on its body and starts to play possum in moments of danger. It closes its bill and its eyes and becomes rigid. Now it looks just like part of a branch. Here is another remarkable design. Even when it closes its eyes, it can still see its surroundings through special openings under its eyelids. When the danger is past, it relaxes and stops acting. Very well, but who taught this bird to act in this way? Again, we come face to face with the truth. It is the flawless and incomparable artistry of God who created everything. Creatures that make clothing. Some animals make clothing to hide themselves from their enemies. The interesting thing is that some larvae, newly hatched young insects, do this. The walking mosaic you see here is actually a small larva. Its costume is made of little pieces of stone that have carefully been placed on it and give it perfect camouflage. Larvae have several different costumes. Just as they have costumes made of smooth little pieces of wood, they also make more showy costumes for themselves from leaves. These creatures newly emerged from the egg know nothing about the outside world. They are little larvae with no intelligence or consciousness. So, why do they load heavy weights on their backs? The activity of these creatures is an intelligently designed method of camouflage. The camouflage does not belong to the creatures that display it, but to another power that rules them. God created all these wonderful qualities of living things. They are all proof of His infinite intelligence and knowledge. The camouflage ability of golden birds, their skill in acting a part, Their qualities of courage and self-sacrifice make them creatures that truly amaze us. This bird that lives in Patagonia makes its nest in an open pasture. Immediately before the mother bird lays the egg, it is covered with earth designs. This is a special defense created to camouflage the egg. So, the eggs will not be noticed in the grass. If a vulture, human beings, or some other danger approaches the nest, the golden bird makes some surprising movements. It leaps out of its nest and begins running. Then it imitates a bird with a broken wing in the grass. When the stranger comes up close to it, it starts to run off again. Farther on, it lies down on the ground again and pretends to be injured. Its purpose is to distract the approaching stranger's attention from the nest. When the danger is sufficiently past, it stops acting and flies back to the nest. Here the bird displays remarkable behavior. It is a great act of self-sacrifice for a little bird to put itself in danger for its young. This self-sacrifice cannot be explained at all by the theory of evolution, which claims that animals are selfish. The example of the golden bird discredits this assumption and shows once again that God has created in animals their intelligent and self-sacrificial behavior. Let's think again. Whenever we look at nature, we always see the same truth. The fact that God has created all animals and every living thing with its perfect qualities is a proof of creation. The methods of camouflage and intelligent behavior that we have seen in this film are only a few examples. Each one of the animal species in nature has its specially created qualities and superior features. All this wondrous creation belongs to Almighty God, the Lord of heaven and earth, and all that lies between. It is the duty of intelligent people to think about God's creation and to exalt and praise Him. A verse in the Quran commands, "All praise belongs to God, the Lord of the heavens and the Lord of the earth, Lord of all the worlds. All greatness belongs to Him in the heavens and earth. He is the Almighty, the All-Wise."